The knife round is going to be well and truly underway. I'm hoping potentially we could get in game to that.
Just what, to cut just, off of just this to cut off your face. There we go. So thank you, production. thank you, Reese. He's just been saved. And yeah, now this is going to go, of course. We want to see whoever's on the CT side going to get that start. And this is going to be a great game, I feel. The teams themselves, the players individually, very, very talented. You sort of have the almost dad-like player on each side. You've got Zeus and Hiko. So it's almost like they match each other quite well. I do have to say, in terms of like talented players, I'm a big fan of the Brazilians. But you look at sort of NA at the moment, and we've already spoke about this sort of idea yesterday when we were talking about switching out players, and you were looking at this sort of against NRG, you were saying, well, who would you actually switch out on Liquid? And that's where things became a little bit difficult. I do feel like Pimp as well on Dust2 was very, very quiet. And of course, I think NRG, they actually went on to win that one, didn't they?
Yeah, I believe they did actually, yes. Yeah. So, well, regardless, we are going to be going now into the pistol round. I feel like it's a good time to focus on the game at hand. Yeah, I have stopped
giggling.
Embracing my inner like schoolgirl or whatever that was. No anime jokes, something like that. It's gonna be armor almost across the board entirely for Liquid. They do have the defuse kit up on Hiko as you would expect, and a smoke as well for him to be able to just try and delay pushes as they come. And that's gonna be him in towards the B site, which you know we normally see teams hit straight off the bat, but this time Immortals are gonna take things a little bit more slowly. They spread out, try to grab map control early on. And while now looking like they want to try and make something happen in towards A. Two players down in Pop Dog, two in towards A main, and that's going to be backed up, of course, by Henny once he throws his flash into the site. It's going to allow them to start to make their way out, and the push is underway. Smoke lands as well. Leech can be the first to fall as he finds the bullet. He's going to be going down. They have to try and play this now with a one-man disadvantage. Nitro quick to equalize things out, and JDM chiming in with one of his own. Going to be able to put it back in with 3-on-3. Helps flagging like a madman. Finds two frags, finds a third. And Electro does fall. Bomb's going to be going down with the man advantage now leaning the way of Immortals. It's all on Hiko and Armorless, naked and afraid. He's going to go down. He did have the kit, but sadly it's not going to be coming into use. As Immortals, they pick up the pistol and leave themselves in a great way to potentially take the first three.
If he's naked, what does he put the kit on?
I don't know. Oh, now I know.
Yeah, of course, just probably holding it. But yeah, we're going to go back into the second round. We do have four rifles coming up on the T side. So playing this one relatively safe. Of course, they've got the long range avenues. And well, in terms of the CT side, we've got those Deegs. So most of the players are going to go for those long range Juans.
Yeah, trying to make the Deagles work at range. Of course, Trade is a map that lends itself quite well to the Deagle pistol round. Currently, we've got three up on a Liege, Nitro, and Pimp. JDM just relegated down to the use, but Hiko trying to make things work with the CZ in hand. On the side of Immortals, they've given a lot of respect to the way of Liquid. It's rifles across the board, with the exception of Bolts, who has got the UMP to try and farm up some cash. Liquid as well, opting to not buy up the armor, does mean, of course, that little does Bolts know, he can actually potentially reek some pretty nice dollars out of this one on the back of that extra, 300% kill bonus. And now Immortals lining up once again in towards this A site, trying to put those rifles to use at longer ranges. Still biding their time, playing things very passively. It's going to be Phelps to start things off. Does take down a Liege, and now they're going to be looking to try and find some leeway out onto water.
And Lucas to grab one more, and already a couple of players drop. They still have most of their upgraded pistols, but as Nitro falls, they lose one more, and it seems to be falling apart a little bit. Maybe Pimp can bring some love for the Deeg at the moment. It doesn't seem to be working out too well, and well, he's going to get pushed by Zeus as well. In terms of the positions for the CT side, it doesn't look like there's going to be any way to get back into the site. And, well, that's not going to help them out at all.
Yeah, no, not at all. It's been completely locked down. They haven't had to take a single gun at the hands of Immortals either. And, well, Pimp and Hiko being the only two players left to try and make anything happen. I suppose they are the two that you would want in this situation. But Bomb is just going to be ticking away with no kit, no armor, and no utility, with a significant man disadvantage as well. Just trying to hide out and towards this B site. Potentially going to pick up some exit frags. Bolt's making his way downtown. Might be able to find one onto the Jason Hiko, who's looking like he's been, like he's DC'd potentially, because, you know, I imagine he would have sprung into action a little bit faster at the death of his teammate directly behind him. So, yeah, we are going to be seeing a pause coming in from Liquid. I imagine it's going to be a technical, seeing as Hiko, Big Daddy Hiko, as you've nicknamed him,
I did not say Big Daddy.
I'm fairly sure you did. Of course, it is going to be a technical pause, sorry, coming in from the side of Liquid. It's going to go 2-0 as Immortals. They pick up
we've lost a second player as well.
Oh, okay. So Henny just taking the time to tab on out. I guess going to go fix something on his end too. It's 2-0 anyway to Immortals. They pick up the pistol and then the anti-eco as well. Only losing one player there. So one rebuy up on their side. And that's in the form of Bolt, who did lose the UMP, which was probably the one gun they could really afford to expend as we head into this. Hopefully the pause isn't going to be too drastically long, though. And, well, I mean, we haven't really seen too much from either side right now to comment on how we think they're going to fare. You know, what is there you could really say?
Phelps had a great pistol. That
yeah, he did have a very good pistol. And yeah. I think he's actually had a fairly good track record of having consistently good pistols, which, you know, he looks to continue throughout this one once again.
No, he's looked good so far in the games today. Of course, as you said, it's not really anything to go on. And, well, we just wait to see what will actually come back up. Of course, not really too much to invest for the Liquid side. Now, they did sort of only half invest into that one, so maybe they could buy a pistol or two up in this one as well. Some teams do opt to do that rather than going for one sort of pistol round. They go for a couple and just basically then buy up anyway. Or they could just opt to go for the complete save and have lots of utility and maybe even a double AWP if they want into the next one. So there's plenty of avenues they can take. Of course, JDM is already set to get the AWP in the next round with the loss bonus coming in. And we've already spoken about the AWP battle. Of course, the player likely to be battling with him currently is not in the server. So that makes things a little bit more difficult. It will be Henny. Although, actually, on their CT side, at least, Phelps, and actually a little bit on the T side in the last matchup on Train with Complexity, was picking up the AWP as well. It would be Phelps. So maybe we won't see Henny AWPing all the time. It has sort of switched around. And I think that was just because Phelps was actually playing very, very well.
Yeah, no, Phelps was having a standout performance with the AWP. You know, Henny, like we say, had fallen off a little bit towards the end of the previous couple of maps. So, yeah, we did see them kind of using Phelps as the primary AWP, making sure Henny had one in his hands whenever they had the money to. But it did seem like more of a priority to be getting it up on Phelps. And that did happen, you know, you saw it slowly transition in throughout Cash, becoming more and more regular, even a little bit maybe on Train as well. But, yeah, it is going to be the case of just waiting for them to get back into the server. I think we are going to be seeing Henny reconnect. His PC crashed, apparently, which is never going to be good. And we're just waiting for Hiko to be restarting his modem, which is all good. So it won't take that long. I mean, 30 seconds is all it's meant to take, but I guess that could be a long way away or something.
Yeah, I think that, well,
I don't know how you're going to carry that on.
Always, no, Hiko's always had sort of internet troubles. I think he's always had problems with his provider. So I'm hoping it isn't anything too serious for him. I wonder if he has... I don't know if they actually play in a house together, but because otherwise that would affect all of them, so I guess not. So really waiting to see for him to get back into the server, but I'm hoping it's not anything too problematic and he will be able to get back in, because, well, let's be honest, who are you going to find to replace Hiko?
Yeah, and that's a task indeed. He's an incredible player for the side of Liquid. But, yeah, so something that you were drawing on a little bit, I guess, is the whole conversation between Henny maybe switching out to the rifles a little bit more and seeing the focus on the AWPing fall onto Phelps, because he was having an unreal game. Currently, I mean, we are already seeing Phelps being, what, 5-1. He had a very good pistol and has found some headshots as well with the rifle in hand on the anti-eco. So, you know, clearly feeling it right now with whatever he kind of has at his disposal. Do you think we might, you know, stand the chance of seeing him falling back into the AWP role, or is a lot of it going to depend on how Henny does at
I
first
with the
AWP? I think
he has to be a secondary AWPer, just because, although we didn't really see it earlier, Henny is an absolutely phenomenal AWPer. There's no doubt about that. Some of the flicks that he's able to pull off are just ridiculous. So to bench him on the AWP, I don't really think there's any value in that, just because he could have a standout round. And it's not like he had a bad game on Train at all. He was second top. The only person above him was Phelps. And most of the time, they both had AWPs. So I think you've got to stick Henny on the AWP for sure. And then you sort of, if you have enough money, then yeah, sure, bring up Phelps. But the difference with this one, I think that they're not going to get away with as much on the T side like they did. Because obviously it was, what was it, 10-5, I think? They only got five rounds. Complexity only got five rounds CT side, if I'm correct. And then they got four on the T side as well. So it was 9 rounds. It is sort of just one of those things that if you do get 10 rounds, eventually the money does get to a point where you can just afford whatever you want. The likelihood of you being economically down and having a 10-round T-side is pretty damn slim, let's be honest, unless you're playing very, very close rounds, which wasn't really the case. They were able to sort of win one, lose one, and then just win something ridiculous like five players alive every single time. In fact, that happened on Cash as well, where they were sort of, even the round when things were going badly on the CT side, the one rounds they would win were every player standing alive. Now, against Complexity, I think that's almost probable, because they are just a better team. Against Liquid, it should never happen. I think the round should be closer, and so more basically, in the most long-winded way ever to get around to answering your question.
It has taken a very long time, but that's all good.
But yeah, getting round to my answer, what I want to say is...
Is it so long-winded?
I just don't think there's going to be much of an opportunity. Of course, we have people talking in our ears. I'm not just mentally insane. But it's one of those positions where it's whether they can get a second AWP. That's what I'm more alluding to, rather than, we should be switching it between da-da-da-da. That's basically saying, it's definitely going to happen where AWPs have a great economy. Because I don't think Liquid will allow them to. I think most rounds we're going to have will be closer, and for them to whitewash, it will have to be on economy breaks, because Liquid are pretty damn good.
So that is a very valid point. So you're thinking, the reason why they were able to support and finance the double up setup previously was as a result of being able to pick up those rounds against Complexity earlier on. And now you're saying that probably isn't going to be possible. You just said that in a very...
I basically wanted to explain myself.
That is fair enough.
Definitely not to do with the pause.
Yeah, but we have been informed, reliably so as well, that Hiko's internet is dead. Rest in peace, 2015 till 2016. I don't know what the date is today. That's what I'm like. Do you know what the date is? Putting you on the spot a bit?
16th, I think.
Yeah, it actually is 16th October.
Surely you can just...
2016.
Shift tab. So
that is going to be Hiko's internet now. So for the time being, they're looking for a backup, apparently, trying to sort that out. But I think that is a valid point. Switching out the whole AWPing stance and saying that because the economy was very, very strong beforehand, they were able to support such a thing. But now they might not. And I think a lot of it is also going to depend on how Henny is fragging straight out of the gate. If he's still having a little bit of a rough patch, you need to have the AWP reliably on this map. And JDM's not someone who's going to go easy on you
if you're comparing
AWP.
Surreal and JDM, there isn't really much of a comparison. I'm not saying you are. Okay. I'm saying that in this sort of form, like you're saying, maybe Henny didn't have that good a game versus Surreal. If you don't have a good game versus JDM, then it's sort of one of those problems. Like, you have to sort of think of that idea that JDM overall should be much better. Like, that's not really anything to argue. That's just JDM. He is the primary AWPer for this team. If he wasn't doing well, they could replace him with somebody else. They're not going to do that, though, because most of the time, he is pretty good. Now, you put me on the spot by asking me who I'm going to highlight. Now, I've already highlighted most of the players, but for Liquid at least, we haven't gone into too much detail about Liquid.
Yeah, sure thing.
Out of all the players, who's your favorite player? I think that's a better way of putting it. We can get some insight into your personal feelings about Team Liquid.
So, yeah, I mean, I have a few on Team Liquid. That feels like I'll take the easy way out.
Name one.
More specifically, I have two that I'm interested in for different reasons.
Whoever you pick first is going to be the one I'm assuming you like the most.
Okay, well then in that case, he doesn't necessarily frag the best, but he can be a huge influence, and it's going to be a Liege, probably mine, just because it depends
what tournament. Young. Sometimes he can frag.
Yeah,
the best,
definitely.
The majors.
And I remember speaking about him the other day, saying that I remember when he first came in with Elevate, year and a half, almost 2 years ago now, and he completely kind of blew all these other teams out the water, sometimes on just a singular performance. And he's kind of one of the players who, from that original core team, has gone on to kind of actually continue and like make some waves within the pro scene of North America. You have seen a few of the others. Oh, I can't actually remember any of his teammates because it was so long ago, and the team didn't really accomplish much either. But
hence they're not around anymore.
Yeah, it is dead.
RIP Elevate.
Yeah. But that's why he's always been a kind of favorite of mine. He started off in this team that was very, very small, as you would expect. And so he's been able to kind of move on from there, keep going. And now we see him in Liquid. He posts very competitive scorelines. He's quite young as well, in all honesty. I believe he's something like...
We've always spoken about the sort of Nitro Liege combo as being a deadly combo in NA. And it did sort of carry over to the majors as well. That seems to be where they just come out and shine. So it is great stuff from them. I do think... especially with Nitro recently, he has sort of been in-game leading, and that's why we have seen a bit of a fall-off, and I think Thorin was making a joke about it, the sort of switch of Liquid. It always is like Nitro goes up, he in-games easy, goes down, then he stops in-game leading, goes back up again, and it's just an almost inevitable cycle of constantly going up and down and up and down, and then they switch it out and somebody else will take the hit. I think Hiko might be in-game leading at the moment, which is a very big problem considering I think he's not coming back.
it does not look good for him. The odds are not in his favour, sadly.
So who's the second player?
What, for the...
You said you had two.
Hiko, obviously, would be my choice as my second number two.
Well, you say obviously, but who would you not name in this team that's a pretty solid player?
There's a lot of strong performers in there. JDM as well with the AWP.
Are you just going to name everyone else?
Yeah, pretty much. Nitro has always been a good...
Don't forget Pimp. We actually haven't said Pimp name once. No. I like him just because he managed to get the name Pimp and just rolled with it. And it like you look at him and you think, the first word that doesn't come to my head is Pimp, but you know what? Maybe I'm wrong.
Well, I mean, you know, speaking of player names who managed to just slip under the radar as being, you know, ones that really should... There's a player by the name of Fuchs, who I'm saying it, you know, in the way that you
careful.
Yeah, in the way that you're meant to say it, if you.
Well, I was a bit worried about Shuz in the last.
Yeah,
game.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, there are just a few names like that where if you read them out phonetically, they're pretty.
You have
horrible.
To be a little bit careful with those.
Yeah, no, I mean it's always interesting to see that just the kind of player names that can slip under the radar is being pretty horrific.
Well, I'm back to.
Oh, yeah,
Pimp,
sorry. Yeah.
Rather than just moving on to names, which is always nice. I think my name is as terrible as any because it's just a combination of my first, last name. But switch to Z's for edginess. Or Z's, I suppose. And, back to Pimp. As an addition to this team, I think he's got big boots to fill. Let's put it that way. Simple, of course, was the one to exit. And I don't think he's ever... the thing is, he's a talented player, but he's not Simple. I don't think he could ever be Simple, because Simple is sort of someone challenging to be maybe even the best player at some point, because he is just constantly getting better and better and has those explosive games in big, big games as well. It's normally when he's on a stage, when he's in a tough situation, that Simple can just come out and show you exactly what he's got. And whether Pimp can ever get to that, I think there were points. I don't think he's ever been as good as Simple. I'm not going to make that comparison because that would be a bit ridiculous. But he has had points in his career when he's been very, very good and a talent for sure. But it's just the boots to fill. I wonder if they can sort of maneuver their team where they're not basically going, hey, Simple, can you win us a game?
Yeah, no. I mean, filling things is always going to be difficult, as you and I are discovering very quickly. But no, in all seriousness, we are just going to be waiting, like we say, for the internet situation to be sorted. Presuming that Hiko isn't coming back, but I mean, I guess we'll be waiting for some more confirmation on that. I imagine Liquid have someone they can call upon in this situation to try and fill the boots of
who you're going
to
call
Hiko. Yeah, who are you going to call?
I genuinely don't know.
You think it's difficult to fill Simple's boots? Imagine. You know, now being told, oh, you know, we have a game versus Immortals. Can you fill Hiko's boots? I mean, I can't think of anyone.
Especially as I imagine there is a rule in this where you can't choose players from other teams. Because I don't know why they'd want to help out anyway. Hey, do you want to help Liquid get some more points in the league?
I mean, well, it depends who you ask. Like,
I feel like most players would. I feel like there has to be a rule, but at the same time, I feel like most players would still probably be like, it would be a. Basically a conflict of interest. Like they would kind of, in a way, want to lose just to make sure that they get the spot, so it wouldn't make any sense for them to stand in. Now, it looks like we have got someone standing in. We've got A2Z currently in the server. Now, I don't have too much info about him, so unless you know some knowledge, I think we are just going to have to play it by ear and see what he can do.
No, I've seen him a little bit. I believe he played on Echo Fox for a while.
I wonder where
he
got that from.
But no, I mean, I have actually seen him only a tiny bit. I haven't really watched him play, I have to be honest with you. But, I mean, if he's filling for Hiko, then he's got to be all right. That's
the thing. He's got to stand in for Hiko, which is going to be tough, especially if Hiko was in-game leading. Like, I cannot confirm or deny if that is true, but from Twitter, which is obviously the most reliable source, there was stuff saying that basically Nitro had stopped in-game leading and that Hiko was going to take over. So if he's now not in the server, yes, of course, if Nitro has been in-game leading, they can just switch it over. But Train isn't exactly one of the maps where you want to be sticking someone in as a fill-in, especially against Immortals. They must be really happy about this now, where they're coming up against a team that could be troublesome in terms of stopping them from getting the 3 points, and now they get to do it without having to face off against Hiko. In every clutch situation, they're going to be like, haha, we feel a little bit better now.
Well, yeah, no, I mean, that's the real thing. Everyone was kind of relying on the fact that Liquid were going to pull through this. The question is, I mean, with a stand-in, can they? And, I mean, now that he's actually in the server, It's looking like we should be started somewhat soon. I mean, we are having a few more issues kind of arising, which is never good. Hopefully this time not with the stand-in.
It's almost like dominoes.
Yeah, one-to-one person gets it. I mean, you notice Hiko drops out, then Henny's PC...
instantly breaks at the same time.
and now, supposedly, the stand-in's having a few issues of his own. But that should be sorted, you know, sooner rather than later. But I mean, you know, the main brunt of the delay is all good. And I mean, it's NA Counter-Strike. There seems to always be delays in the NA stuff.
Yeah, no, there does.
Not to say that EU's plain sailing. Believe me, we know that it's not. But I mean, in all the NA games we've done, have they ever been able to finish on time? Because I feel like
yesterday was actually all
yesterday
right.
was
like,
good.
I think I felt like we finished early, but I think the schedule did actually change halfway through. So maybe that was more of the reason that we finished at a normal time. Of course, the other day we were supposed to finish at 3 and finished at 4, so that one definitely didn't work out. But it happens. Of course, delays are always going to be a part of a game that involves internet, computers, and people. I suppose the people can be a pain themselves. I'm not going to say any names because I don't actually have any off the top of my head, but
I'm
sure people can, of course, cause problems themselves.
Have you ever thought about perhaps trying to style the limited portion of hair that you have?
No, I'm just going to roll with it.
There's more to the question. I'm happy that you answered it already.
Yeah, because it's not going to be a question I want to answer.
I was going to say, potentially, and I'll happily lend you some of mine because we all know I have more than enough to give, potentially into some sort of horn. Whether that's to look like...
I've been told that because of the amount of hair I have, I could do a mohawk. If I just, because I'm pretty much going that way anyway.
I can neither confirm or deny that. It's,
we're just like it's a thin layer of mohawk.
It's not looking good, though, from the outset. I can tell you that much. Maybe. I mean, it would dip down at the front quite considerably. But why not?
Like a short one. Basically what I mean is I shave the sides even more.
Okay, right. No, that's fair enough.
Like just a no hair mohawk.
That doesn't sound like a thing. have you ever considered just going fully bald, like just jumping in at the deep end? Or are you feeling?
I don't know. I think I'd miss the little patch.
No. I don't blame you. It gives you something to play around. I mean, I'm
something to play around with.
Yeah.
Was that genuinely the point you were gonna make at this point? I think we're completely lost in hair talks. I'm wondering, can you buy a headset that doesn't cause
horrifically?
No,
you cannot. I have tried many a time on how to fix it. The only solution is get your hair cut really short.
Also, before Counter-Strike, were you ever compared? Grow a big beard.
Grow a beard is what the producer just told us.
Have you ever been compared to Rick Ashley before?
My girlfriend makes the comparison. You know, as a joke, in jest, her parents do too.
But surely that means she's happy to date Rick Ashley.
Oh no.
That's what she's basically implied.
Never.
So she's never going to give you up, I guess.
No, she'll never give me up, and I'm never going to let her down. So
I'm not sure I believe that.
We come full circle, basically. Yeah, no, I've been liking Rick Ashley. The more familiar one is actually the Jimmy Neutron thing. I actually have a JPEG of Jimmy Neutron on our streaming.
Opening up on the PC, like midway through the game, you were just writing James Bardolph's name on the map.
You didn't read it. Actually, James Badolph, changing it around a little bit. I wrote it in nice multicolored as well. It kept switching it up on the map.
And you had a picture of his face zoomed in, which
not drawn. That would
you did.
That'd be incredibly talented.
If you did that during the map while casting, I'm creating
works of art while I do this. But so hang on. We're seeing. What's the issue right now?
Wait,
oh, okay. Tab? So, it's going all good apart from the money right now needs to be sorted out in game, which is always.
I thought that might be ping. I was like, if he's on 800 ping, then we really are screwed. But no, it's just money. He needs to get the money sorted out. So. Hopefully, once that is sorted, it looks like everybody in the server has just died. So hopefully that will be the case. The only problem is, of course, A2Z wasn't actually in the game. So it's not like being reset to what he was before. They actually have to add it in. So that makes a bit more of a pain in terms of the money.
Yeah, you have to hope the maths is good as well. So reliably, you know, you're not one of the admins responsible for that.
Neither are you.
Yeah, no, okay.
Because you would get it right and then change your mind and
that is true.
Get it
that
wrong
is
afterwards.
Basically me in a nutshell. But you make great decisions. Do a complete wrong 80? Do a complete 180? To be fair, that is what they are. They are wrong 80s.
A complete wrong 80. There you go. New phrase for the chat.
Okay, I think it's actually getting somewhere. They've finally been able to get ATZ back in the server. So it is looking optimistic. And there we go. Oh, it took so incredibly long, but we are back. Liquid versus Immortals.
Nice
The game that you actually all came here to see, and not man with too much hair who looks like child talking to man with too little hair who looks like his father. We're actually going to be getting in game. Liquid versus Immortals. First map of the night on train. What's the time? It's, you know, it should be
it's
over by now.
It's Counter-Strike o'clock.
Right, we're ready to go. Are we? Well, the pause is still in effect, but I hope we're ready to go.
Yeah, it looks like we will be getting back into this one. Hopefully, relatively shortly. I do like the pictures of a drum. Well done. Well done, guys. I think you missed that. But they had the little Liquid symbol drawn and the Immortal symbol drawn.
Yeah, no, I thought that was good. No, the drawing. I couldn't even tell they were...
Art by Boaster.
Oh, okay.
There you go.
Yeah,
so there is some talent Boaster in the UK scene.
Yeah, no. Yeah. Oh, wow.
He's not going to be happy about that.
That is very
true. He's got some drawing talent. That's something. And he can play the ukulele as well. So
can he actually?
Yeah, well, you know, he was singing earlier. He was singing, what was it, the other day? Playing a little song. I'm sure you were there for that.
I think I probably was. It's just
you've died about
UKCS
four times since then.
Fades away. So it's going to be... We're going to be finally getting back into this. And while Nitro and Pimp being the first to fall, it's a 3 versus 5.
Nitro dunks Pimp.
We've got three USPs or USPs on the side of Liquid to try and come back from this one. And, well,
what a way to come back, to kill your teammate with a nade. Okay. JDM, though, will get one with the pistol. So something to play with at least. But it is only one kill. An extra $300 for him is going to be welcomed, of course, as he wants to get the AWP as soon as possible. And now Elige is there to try and spam this one away. Wants to get something for his troubles, but it will not happen.
Yep, the third round going to be going the way of the Immortals, that they pick that one up. Finally, Liquid presenting with the chance to buy and a chance to play, as we have come out of the pause now well and truly. We've got the AWP up on JDM, which is always nice to see. Plenty of utility as well for Liquid to play around with. 4 rifles and just a shed load of smokes and flashes for them to try and delay the push. What Immortals eventually do. You've got the AWP up on Phelps on the flip side of things, and, well, they do both miss the shot over and in towards mid. At B, it's all Nitro trying to be the anchor of this B site. Immortals, on the other hand, while they're taking map control early on, you've got Zeus and Henny slowly making their way down in towards Ivy, and A2Z, he's the player to try and hold this back.
Shall we look towards Henny? Of course, we've already highlighted every single player that we can, but he was one of the first, so he can take props for that at least. Lucas is going to be looking to come out of pop, but the smoke will fall, denying any push that he hopes to make. And well, currently the utility being used well by the CT side to just slow down any aggression that can be had by Immortals. Angle is currently being held, and well, there goes Elige, aggressive push in. Phelps will be lost early on, and it's still 55 seconds left. The T's will make their move. Electric Box has been taken by Lucas, some map control at least, but I don't think he knows the position of Elige anymore. And actually, the peek from Elige is going to be perfect, but Lucas still finds the frag anyway. Trade back to a 4 versus 4. Now the round looks to be rotating back. They're not going to push through the Ivy position, and well, this leaves them quite isolated. They've got to make their push very, very quickly. Lucas is still going to be leading the charge, but they have to be very careful because the bomb is now out in the open with two players still looking to fall in. Lucas, though, he's doing it all alone, and he's found 3 kills. Nice round from Lucas. It's only going to be Pimp and Nitro to try and hold on to this one.
Yep, it's a 2 versus 3. Quickly turned into a 2-on-2, though, as Nitro and Pimp both pick up a frag apiece, and now it's all Zeus and Henny. Got to try and defend this bomb plant. Time is ticking down, and it is of the essence. Currently, they're looking in a fairly good spot to try and hold this back. Nitro tries to go aggressive, but Zeus is going to be able to hear him out. Looks away at just the wrong time, and they walk past each other. 4 by 3 coming into full effect, but Zeus finally spots it out. And now it's only Pimp, 13 HP. He knows where one of these players are, but that's going to be it. And, well, playing around the electric box perfectly, Zeus able to pick up that frag, takes down Pimp, and cements a 4th round on the board for Immortals.
Yeah, of course, not the best start already. And, oh no. Ah, oh, Hiko's back, or coming back, or on his way back, or something. So, yay.
Yeah, Hiko's going to be all good. Apparently his internet is back and working fine, and just like that, they say, you know, ATZ, see ya. It was nice having you, but, you know, Hiko, the daddy. The daddy of Liquid has returned.
Daddy's back.
Daddy's home, and he's bringing the full wrath of internet anger with him.
Well, yeah, no,
he's actually incredibly mellow, in all honesty, so I couldn't...
I think even the mellowest of people, if you're about to play a professional game, and we know how serious he is about that, to get kicked off because of his internet provider, I'm sure he's not too happy about that one.
The only issue is I think now we have to sort out the money again, but that's only a couple more minutes. 90 seconds, we've just been told. So how fantastic is that? So far, though, we have seen 4 rounds in an hour, which, you know, probably takes the record for longest rounds of Counter-Strike ever.
I doubt that.
No, yeah, no.
Some of the delays that some of the tournaments have had and finishing very, very late. But, yeah, it's been interesting. I think we found out a little bit more about each other and now built up our inner hatred of each other as well for taking the mickey out of each other's hair. So,
yeah, no, it was good.
We're going to release that hatred after this map finishes, if it ever does.
Yeah, no, sorry, delays are just appearing to run rife today in this game. But, I mean, you know what they say, it's gone fairly swimmingly up until now, no problems. Last game of the night, Liquid versus Immortals, probably the game that everyone's been most looking forward to. And, well, bam, just loads them. I just hit the desk, worried I'm going to be breaking Faceit's property, and then I'll be fired forever. But, yeah, there we go, there's the bell instead. Courtesy of Tom.
Yeah, we do have multiple bells on this desk.
Wow, okay. Yeah, it's we are just waiting for Vigo to get on in. Apparently, it should be all good now as he's just trying to join the server. There's a few issues with the Steam ID not being allowed. But I think it should be sorted, hopefully. But anyway, okay.
Come on, pick up the phone.
That was, regardless, that was a rifle round that we saw a minute ago. So
hey. That
does give us... Oh! Finally,
Hiko. Boys are back in town.
He has returned. The prophecy as it foretold. And on the 5th round, Big Daddy shall returneth from the other side of no internet and reap Immortals' sins for all they have done. And, well, that's exactly what I'm going to be seeing. Liquid versus Immortals. It's finally kicking off for real this time. Not like the last time where I said it was kicking off and it didn't. This is it. It is live. There's going to be no more problems. And we're all good. Can't promise you any of those things, by the way. But, yeah.
Disclaimer at the end. It's like reading the fine print. Nobody was listening to that bit anyway. Either way, Lucas is going to be looking to push out, but Phelps beats him to the punch. We'll start things off and, well, looks to continue. Looking to clean everyone up at the moment, in fact. He's got himself a third kill into this round, getting those eco frags until Nitro denies him any more.
Yeah, that round a complete mop-up as Liquid, they get completely demolished. Nitro able to find one. But Immortals ultimately coming up ahead. They find the 5th round on the board, and now Liquid, they can finally buy on down. They've got the full family back together, and they are ready to go. We've got rifles across the board. You've also got an AWP up on Pimp and an AWP on JDM. They're going to be going for the double AWP setup, as you would expect, on Train. A good bit of utility as well, just to throw into the mix. And Immortals, on the other hand, plenty of money in the bank and plenty of utility on the board. It's going to be an exciting 6th round, to say the least.
Definitely want to see this double AWP in full flow for the CT side. It has come in. It will be the change that they've made to their setup. And, well, there's only one on the T side at the moment. Of course, we do know that at points it has been false, but he's doing pretty well with the rifle at the moment. So I don't know why he'd be opting to change that anytime soon. It is looking like Immortals are about to go for a smoke setup over towards the A site. They do have a couple of players over in Pop Dog at the moment. And, well, they're going to look to try and explode onto the site relatively soon. Of course, the counter smoke has actually held Lucas in position. And while with Pimp holding with the AWP, it does look like they've thrown out a lot of utility, but are not going to pounce just yet. They still have 3 smokes in play, so aren't really needing to go anywhere just yet. 55 seconds left on the clock and plenty still to play with. Of course, the CT utility is mainly just flashbangs now. In fact, a hell of a lot of flashbangs other than the 1 HE onto Nitro. So all we really need to look towards now is Immortals, and here we go. Looking like the setup will retake shape with a push from Ivy coming out from Zeus. But now they will make their way forward, and it's Pimp. He starts things off with the headshot.
Yeah, going to be finding that first frag, and as a result, the push from Immortals is going to be slowed down considerably. Finally, Bolt's there to refrag, and the momentum picks back up. Nitro's able to take down Zeus, but as Lucas gets aggressive onto the site, it was looking like I would find a couple of frags, but they get completely shut down. Now it's all Phelps, 1 versus 4, able to find one frag. It's JDM to fall, but Nitro in a very good place to do some damage, puts him onto 8 HP. Phelps not ready to give up just yet, but sadly, bullets would have it that way. The Leech finds the kill. It's going to go 1-5, and Liquid, they get their first round on the board.
They do lose one of their ops, though, so I don't think they're going to get the second one back into play. So already, that expensive setup seems to have been lost, so that's going to be a bit of a problem for this CT side. Now, in terms of the rest, they will be able to get full rifles and everything on the board on both sides, especially in terms of utility, Molotovs, and, well, kits across every single player. So not too much of a problem as of yet. It will be an aggressive push again. Henny going to be looking for the peak with the AWP. JDM is close, and it's going to be Henny just catching the arm of JDM to start things off with the first kill of the round. And well, it's gone down to no ops at the moment on the CT side.
Yeah, they lose the op on the back of JDM, and sadly, the pimp this time doesn't have his in hand. So the man advantage and somewhat the weapon advantage is going to be going the way of Immortals here. They'll be looking to take full advantage of that by committing to this A attack as well. You have the AWP up on Henny, and that's gonna be very favorable in terms of these long-range engagements. Zeus going to be able to find one. Nitro, let's chime in back with one on the AWP. And as a result, it's going to be at 4 versus 3 now, and the push is still looking like it's going to make its way towards A. They're not really ready for Pimp, who's gone very aggressive on the other side of the smoke. Finds one under Phelps. Lucas, meanwhile, he's gone aggressive out onto the site. He's able to take down Nitro, who's had an impact in this round in a big way. And Pimp falls as well, so the positioning is going to be going the way of Immortals. Hiko, the player have to try and rotate on through, looks at the Molotov in disgust, and has decided he's going to try and go for this one. 1 versus 3, making his way through the smoke, looking to deny the plant. Be able to find the first frag, look for the second as well, and it looked like he was going to get it, but Bolt comes in and saves the life of Henny there as he was trying to get that bomb down. Daddy sadly unable to bring home the bacon in that situation.
Well, yeah, I think even though it was a 1 versus 3, there's always going to be some belief in Hiko. That's never going to be a doubt. But at least in this position, it's not going to be a goodbye coming back up for Liquid. They have been reset. Nova onto Hiko, so he will be trying at least to make some money. And, well, I do love the pump action shotgun.
Yeah, it's always refreshing to see Hiko trying to bring the Nova into the mix, playing over towards that B site, just being the anchor role. And, well, couldn't think of a better situation for him to be in right now with the shotgun in hand. Able to get one or two frags and be able to do some damage on the burst, but doesn't find a kill out of it. Lucas takes him down. And now Pimp with the scout trying to put the hurt onto the remaining members of Immortals as they make their way towards the B site. He's going to get Molotov down of position, and the rotate's going to be completely just grinding to a halt. Henny pushed back in towards the tunnels, might be able to spot out JDM, who's a little bit clueless as to the positioning here. Is finally going to be able to spot him out and finds him with a P250. As a result, it's a 3-on-3. Nitro has an AK as well. A save here wouldn't be entirely out of the question because Zeus can find that frag out onto Nitro. Now it's just Pimp and JDM. Going to try and reconvene together, but Bolt, he doesn't want these two players to save just yet. As Pimp falls, it's only JDM 1 versus 3, and now he's stuck between, you know, dying in a fiery explosion or dying at the hand of, you know, the Brazilians, and it looks like he's going to choose going down to Immortals as Bolt is able to finish him off. It's going to go 1-7, and they manage to leap ahead into the lead.
Yeah, a little bit unlucky there, because there was actually nobody towards the site, so if he pushed the other way, he would have had a chance, but obviously you're more likely to fall away from the site than expecting there to be nobody there. Of course, it is going to be one round at the moment for the CT side. Immortals having a phenomenal start to this game, and well, after that somewhat forced by coming in the last, it's going to be nothing this time but pistols for the Liquid side of things. And Immortals, well, they've started strong and they look to continue in this round.
Yeah, a 6-round lead currently over Liquid, and well, they're looking to try and widen that lead that much more. 6 rounds of the difference currently, like we say. And well, with Liquid being on the eco right now, it's a very good chance for Immortals to try and capitalize on that. Bolt's going to be able to find two. Henny as well. Phelps getting one on a Hiko. Suddenly, it's all going to be on Pimp. 1 versus 5. It's even going to be hard to hit for him to try and find at least some damage into this round.
Yeah, we'll be tapping away with the pistol and done a lot of damage onto Phelps, but damage isn't going to help him out. 11 HP will be enough for Phelps to survive as they keep every single player. Their money is starting to boom. And, well, so far, it's been our man Phelps again, starting very, very strongly. I think you do have to give some props to Lucas as well. Some of his entry fragging has been very prominent so far in this game. And while Bolt's the silent fragger, always seems to be just chugging along. But back in play, the double AWP setup will be there for Liquid. For
yeah,
a matter of seconds.
Straight away, I mean, it's going to get shut down. JDM falls as Phelps finds him, showing that he's incredibly talented with the AK. Of course, winning that duel against the AWP on JDM is
He had the timing on the AWP, so Phelps had the AWP.
Oh, right, okay. Yeah, okay, right.
It was still a lovely shot, so either way, it is that opening pick going away.
I thought he had one, and I was really confused when I looked back. Yeah,
no, yeah, they switched it for the timing shot. So they've done that a couple of times, actually. It's quite a nice way to start off the round, the positional spawn, giving the advantage over to Phelps. And he's hit that both times. I think we've seen them do that. So, yeah, nice work from him. Already we're going to see another one come in when the AWP falls back into Henny's hand. So that AWP has found 2 kills on 2 different players.
Yeah, and Immortals now, they have the man advantage very much significantly so, and you can already see Liquid going to be taking this very passively. It's all going to be Hiko in this B site to try and hold it back once again. And well, as it looks like they'll be on the push, he's going to get taken down straight away. Lucas able to take him down. And now Pip rotating in with the AWP in hand. He's going to be trying to get out of there with his life. And he can, by the skin of his teeth, narrowly avoids death. Sadly, death comes in many ways. And Phelps, well, he's a very swift deliverer of it next day, I believe. He tries to make his way in through the A site. Wants to track down both these players. Going to be able to hear them out. Well, peeking around the corner, Fate's going to be there, but Pimp, he's going to get dropped. I don't think they're going to expect the Liege to be in the same place in this corner. But I mean, Phelps is still looking to be very, very curious as to what is going to have in store. And oh, he pre-fires it on the 1-8. He just takes him down. That's what you want to see. A Liege is going to fall. And Immortals, they are looking so incredibly strong. It is top form right now from them.
Well, I don't know what changed from them playing earlier. But it definitely isn't Phelps, because Phelps is just on point again, just cleaning up all of those kills towards the end. This time he will challenge with the AK. Of course, it is only pistols into this round once again for Liquid. They really are struggling on the economy front, getting reset left, right, and center. And, well, look, because this flash isn't going to go down into Pop Dog, as it's been blocked by a teammate. But Hiko, well, he's ready with the CZ. Maybe he'll have to get himself a kill. Possibly two if he's lucky, but they are all coming down at once. And well, he'll spray away, do some damage to Zeus, but damage is all he will get. The Molotov going down will stop any form of rotation coming out, as the last man left alive is JDM. He's going to be tapping away, but he cannot connect as Bolts finish the round. And another clean one coming out for Immortals. They're making up so much money at the moment. In fact, well, nearly every player above 10,000, only Henny slightly behind on 9,000.
Yeah, I know. The money is stacking up on the side of Immortals. And, well, for the side of Liquid, it's non-existent. Hiko going to be buying the auto-sniper as anyway, perhaps in a little bit of a desperation act to try and make this work. It is very effective on train. We do see a lot of teams actually opt to pick it on up. So, you know, not that surprising to see it being brought into play. And, well, the push is on the way out towards his A-site. Pimp fluffing his shot, which really should have been hitting. Zeus going to be able to fire one. Henny as well takes down Nitro. The A-site just being completely demolished. And this level of destruction should be illegal, as it's going to be a 5 versus 3. The three remaining players for Liquid, all with scoped rifles. Hiko trying to make things work. Finds one out on a Lucas. That's going to help make their way in towards this B-site. But it's still not a good outlook as a whole. Pimp is able to escape from heaven. Jumps down with the AWP in hand. Tries to spot out a player on his approach, but he's going to get dropped. Zeus finds one, heading through the wall, through the train, takes down JDM, and it's all Hiko with the auto sniper. 1 versus 3. And, well, sadly, it's not going to be a good prospect for him to try and go for this one.
Yep, Phelps, well, he is the king of getting those exit frags in these rounds, finishing off any of the remaining players every single time. And, well, the one thing about an auto sniper is it really isn't the weapon for a retake. I don't think Hiko did anything particularly wrong. He manages to get two kills and giving it a go, but just that A-hold at the moment, it really is not working out. They seem to lose players so very quickly. The aggressive pushes from Immortals are just not being shut down at the moment by the Liquid side. And, well, this is an absolutely dominating performance from them. Whoa! Flick from Henny comes in, and he takes down a Liege. And, yes, it's only a pistol, but that flick was just incredible. So quick at the moment. And, well, he's not having to do too much. He is currently bottom of the board, 7-2.
Yeah, but I mean, that's the thing. It's not that he's not hitting his shots. There just aren't any enemies left for him to kill. Liquid dropping like flies. Phelps again, once out towards this B site, takes down Hiko. It's going to go the way of Immortals very quickly early on. No one left on B to try and hold things back. Pimp's very far away, has the Deagle out, trying to find some sort of leeway into this round, but he hasn't had much success. JDM, meanwhile, going to fall at the hands of Henny, just dominating with that AWP. It's the preferred weapon of JDM as well, so it's like a double kick in the teeth. And, well, now it's just Pimp, 1 versus 5. He's got a Deagle, gives it a little mouse shake of positivity. Let's see if that's going to provide him the magic he needs. And no, sadly, it made him more of a magnet for Phelps' bullets, which is exactly what seems to be happening tonight. It's going to go 1-12 as Immortals. They have a phenomenal first half so far.
Look at their money.
Yeah, no, they
lowest amount of money they have is 13,400. They didn't even have to use many nades there. Just see from the rebuys that the max they spent up was 1,200. It's just ridiculous at this stage. And once again, we're going to see the double AWP in play. No timing shot this time, but it doesn't matter. Pimp still misses. And that's the second time, I think, now that that's an open shot ready for him to take. And Henny, well, he'll peek out and win the duel. It has not been good for Liquid.
No, not at all. I mean, this is very quickly becoming such a grim outlook. JDM finds a little bit of damage, and that's kind of the best thing they've been able to achieve early on so far. Immortals not giving anything the way of Liquid in the early stages of this. Henny is going to be able to escape with his life, though a little bit of damage done into his wrist as the bullet did penetrate through on there. But he's still going fine. He's such a machine. Who can blame him? Phelps as well, finding another, just refusing to go down. Takes down Nitro out in towards this A site. Going to weaken the hold that much more. Allegiance had to push up aggressively as a result to try and fill the boots of Nitro. You can see him and JDM, sorry, in an okay position to try and trade this out. The issue is they basically rotated everyone out of position in towards his A site. And Henny, how did you even hit that shot? He saw his arm for about half a second. That's going to win them control of B once again. It's all on JDM and Allege, 2 versus 4, and they have to save.
Yeah, when you're this far down, even saving seems to be a little bit pointless. A CT map and 13 rounds, the minimum Immortals are going to be getting. It's done. This has to be one of the greatest comebacks pretty much ever on the T side of a heavily CT-sided map. This is absolutely ridiculous. It's almost as if Immortals can do whatever they want. They can push out, they can finish off players, and, well, towards the end of rounds, they just go running around the map. There's no point in them saving. Why would they bother? Look how much cash they have. Even when they rebuy, they've still got 10k plus. Absolutely ridiculous at the moment. And just Henny, every single time he's able to do anything he wants with this. Phelps is having a great game, and at the moment, it isn't even looking like Liquid are on the map.
Yeah, I mean, Immortals are one of these teams that can take an enemy's strength and kind of turn it against them. Like when we saw earlier against Complexity, they can turn their aggression and kind of wildcardness completely on its head and flip that around and make it their biggest disadvantage. Unfortunately, the trait they take from Liquid is Hiko's inhuman reactions, because the speed today on Immortals has been insane. They've been hitting all their shots. You cannot fault them. The highest fragger in the server on the side of Liquid is Pimper JDM, both on 5 frags apiece. You know, it's really starting to look...
It's not even like there's one player. Like, sometimes you have a player who's having an okay game, and you go, oh, well, maybe there's something they could have done. Like, you talk about the sort of MBK earlier when he was having a good game, and you're saying, oh, well, MBK, he's going to try and fight this one. But there is nothing. There is literally nothing to talk about for the Liquid side. They are being absolutely dominated wherever Immortals decide to go. Immortals, they go, okay, we want this bit of the map, and they have it.
Yeah, it's an incredibly one-sided affair right now. 3 Famuses up for Liquid, and Immortals, they're trying to take map control, just swarming around the map. Bolt's going to be able to find one out onto Pimp, in over towards B. Hiko now left to stand there alone and scared, and, well, Nitro going to flash himself out. Even with the flash, he's going to get taken down. Zeus still finds the frag. And, well, now it's a 5-on-2. Allege falls from the flank from Phelps, and, well, it was all Hiko at the end. 1 versus 5, couldn't find anything. It's a 1-14 scoreline at halftime in favor of Immortals. I mean, how I'm looking at you, Thomas, to try and break this one down.
Can we bring back A2Z and give them a 6th player? Like, not even take anyone out, just give them the extra player. It might make things a little bit fairer, because that was just slaughter. That was absolutely ridiculous from Immortals. I want to give props to them, but at the same time, you have to just wonder what on earth is going on in this match at the moment. There's not even sort of... The one round they won was a double AWP setup. They brought it in multiple other times to try it again. It didn't work. Immortals, well, they're already going to start off the pistol with the headshot onto Allege, and they're looking to continue this even more and just take it 16-1.
Yeah. Pimp does that on a nice shot, actually, out with the Glock, and Hiko as well chiming in with one of his own. Looking to try and do some work, but Henny doesn't want that to happen. He's going to find 2 fast back-to-back frags, and then it's Phelps to finish that one off. It was looking like Liquid had potentially found their foot in the door. And then Henny, I can't even describe what I just saw then. This man is a machine.
Well, I think that's the ding, ding, ding KO sound. That's what I was going for there, because this is a knockout blow. This is ridiculous. The best they can have in the, well, probably the only buy, unless they pull this off with pistols, is going to be this. Like, this is the best buy they could have on the T side, unless they win this round. I haven't seen a game this dominating in a long time, especially not here. Like, this is ridiculous. Complexity got 9 rounds. Immortals I think Immortals have played a much better game. They're not missing anything, but at the same time, no matter what happens, you shouldn't be losing this badly, Liquid. How is this happening?
Yeah. No, I mean, right now, you can just imagine it. Phelps is sitting there decked out. at home in just full leather with a riding crop. He is just a dominatrix tonight. He's ready to go, and he's just showing no sign of slowing it down yet. Lucas start things off, takes down Nitro, gonna be looking for a second. Hiko is able to trade things out. It's a 4-on-4, the push is coming underway, but they've still got to contend with Phelps, who's been such a huge problem. And well, he is ready, biding his time, and all prepared just to knock down some heads.
Yeah, Henny, Bob continuing, and Bob not gonna get all of the players. He's gonna leave some for the rest of his team. JDM will at least step up with the tech, but it is a 16-1.